and they hate that. And they hate that. I ain't even hungry, but I ate that. I keep on winning, and they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that.
Yeah. What's up?
Eat them up, yo.
Yeah, I was on a little diet.
Eat them up.
Even if they're
hungry,
we're gonna give it to them.
Eat them up. I could do it better than he can. Really like that, no pretend. Had to get him back just to revenge. I might go to Paris for the weekend. I might go with it for the weekend. Sports mode, cause I be speeding. No safety, I'm bleeding. I can never fumble like defense.
Going hard for my sisters. Hurry up, take my picture. Heels hurt, I got blisters. Touchdown, make me richer.
It was once just an idea until breaking ground in November of 2016, and now here it is in all its glory. Spectacular SoFi Stadium here in metropolitan Los Angeles. Today we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Cleveland Browns and the Los Angeles Chargers. Strap in, this will be a good one. Two one-loss teams getting together as they're underway on EA Sports. For Derrick Henry, and he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It'll go as a loss of a yard on the game's first play. Second down.
At the 24-yard line.
It's Herbert. Looking left side, and it's complete. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. A big game that time for the Chargers.
We expected this defense to be tested by this passing game coming into this one. And there's an example on this first possession of the game.
So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. That'll be caught. It's Isabella. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. A big game that time for the Chargers.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
Give him 4 on the carry there. It's second and goal. Henry again, and he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3. Looking to cash in on this opening drive. Here's third and goal.
Thanks,
Henry. Yeah, Henry fighting for the marker, but I don't think he got there. He did not. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. That's to his running back, complete. Touchdown! Derrick Henry, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Chargers take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Extra point by McCann, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. McCann's got it teed up. On the return, Rondell Moore will bring it out. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Carry for Nick Chubb, and they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Well, this defense for the Chargers, they played really well in the win over the Raiders a week ago.
It's a little bit enlightening talking to the defense coordinator about their performance last week, because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a hole. He'll wind up getting four there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation. To throw is Watson. Being chased out left. And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a first down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield.
But Deshaun Watson, when you think about the toughest quarterbacks in the league to game plan against, he's got to be in your top five, does he not?
And when you talk about game planning, putting him in the top five, that's an easy call, because he can make every throw. That's not an issue at all. He has great touch delivering the football. But that mobility, that added dimension, oh, when he escapes the pocket and those receivers find their way open, short, medium, and long, he finds the right guy. And last but not least, his toughness. He can stand in the pocket, take a hit, and deliver.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Watson now to throw. And he will find the rookie from Purdue. That's Rondell Moore.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against him a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
A first carry now for Kareem Hunt, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Down by Drew Tranquil. A gain of 2 brings up second and 8.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Second and 8 coming up. Running with Hunt here out of the shotgun. And he'll be close to a first down at the Chargers' 18-yard line. It's a gain of 6, moves him to a manageable 3rd-and-2 situation. Third down.
trying to run for the first down with Hunt. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big third down pickup to keep their drive alive.
They'll run with Chubb, and this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you're looking for at the inside linebacker spot. Versatility. He can drop into coverage, or as he did on that last play, use his speed to get to the perimeter and knock the ball carrier for a loss.
So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. They'll try the air now with Watson. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the 5 here as he's out at the 6. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal. Here's Watson. Steps away to his left. So no sack. He gets back to the line of scrimmage, but it will still bring up a fourth down.
Well, there was pressure all around him, so the only play was to try and get out of there. I think it was an excellent effort by him just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
And this one is right through. So a long drive gets him down inside the 5, but ultimately they settle for just the field goal.
And I have to think that if maybe they were a yard closer, that would have made their decision tougher, and I think they likely would have gone for it. But in this situation, they just decided to take the 3, and I think it was a smart move.
The Charger drive about to get going. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for 4 quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And they finally get him, but not before he reaches the 33-yard line. A big play there for L.A. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped.
And Derrick Henry with the ball in his hands, what a sight to behold, because power and speed involved in every touch for him. Coming off another spectacular season with the Titans, it became the first since LaDainian Tomlinson in 2006 and 2007.
And this will be caught in the end zone for the Chargers touchdown. Andy Isabella, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Chargers find a way to stretch their lead. Extra point by McCann, up and good. And that pushes the lead up to 11. McCann's got it teed up. We'll see a return here from the end zone. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. Their deficit is 11, 14-3, and needing to get something going here as they come up on 1st and 10. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. That's sacked by Khalil Mack.
You say Khalil Mack, and offensive coordinators get very, very nervous, and there's another example of exactly why. 9 sacks in 2020. He's been named to 6 consecutive Pro Bowls and been an All-Pro in 2 of the previous 3 seasons in Chicago.
To try again after the sack. Watson, this is the tight end, Njoku.
It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. Now it's Watson. That's to the right side and complete to Njoku. And he is going to have a Browns first down, although it doesn't appear to be by much. He needed four, and he got four on third down. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. They'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
Now, loose football. The ball comes out and picked up by the Chargers. And he takes it back to the house. It's a fumble recovery and a Charger touchdown. Even the great ones, some of the best, they're not immune to the fumble, and here it really hurts them.
If the ball gets away from any runner's body, that's when the defense pokes at it, swipes at it, swats at it, and finds a way to create a big play for themselves.
Extra point by McCann, up and good, and the lead is up to 18 now. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. The Browns drive about to get started. And this, let's face it, an important drive if they're going to get back into this ballgame.
Think about going into the locker room down 21-10. As opposed
to, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. The former number 3 pick, Joey Bosa, bringing the lumber that time. They'll run with Hunt on second down. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. Watson. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. First and 10 here. You know, if they could just get 3 out of this, there's something about narrowing it to a 2-score game at half that makes it feel like much less of an obstacle. He's got Njoku, his big tight end. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and 4. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number 1. Working with a second and 4. Back to throw, Watson. Swings this out for Hunt. The Browns will quickly use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number 1. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them that they need him late in the game. His confidence should be sky high.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Charger drive about to get going. And with only 9 seconds remaining, and not much time, we'll see how they play this. They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number 2. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he's going to have a first down, but not sure it'll matter as the clock will continue to run. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. A solid run by Derrick Henry, and here's another first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. First down and much more for Henry. And he's going to get this into enemy territory at the 45. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Browns going to see the football first, but they trail here as we resume play on EA Sports. No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. And right out of the gate, they face what you think could be a pretty important drive.
I would say so. You know, they're down two scores. That's not the end of the world. It wasn't the strongest of first halves, but for them to start clawing back, they've got to start putting a little pressure on that defense, start cutting into this deficit. You can't have three and outs and expect to get that done.
So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Watson, off play action. Chargers able to get the pressure and bring him down. Khalil Mack able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. The chain, second and 13. From the gun, it's a gift to Chubb. And he's going to get across midfield and into Charger territory.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
They'll lead the 39 here for a first. This is third down. Now Watson. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been any. This defense has been all over.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. They will indeed snap it to Watson. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Derwin James with a pick, and the Chargers are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line. The first half did not go their way, and that's not going to help matters at all. An interception here on the opening drive of the third quarter.
Obviously not what they were striving to accomplish, but you know who's really upset on their team? The defense. Already trailing, they're going to be counted on to try and hold that score at least where it is.
After the turnover, here's Herbert. This will go to Henry out wide. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45.
And how'd you like to be a cornerback, having to come up to try and tackle that big man out of the backfield? Heck, how'd you like to be a linebacker or a defensive lineman? Because he's as big as all of them. Derrick Henry, not utilized a whole lot in the passing game, just 19 catches a year ago. But when you swing it to him out of the backfield, look out.
Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter. On second down, it's Henry. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. 60 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
Herbert on first down now. 20! And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. A big game that time for the Chargers.
They came out with an aggressive mindset to start the third quarter, and I wouldn't be surprised to see them take more of these type of deep shots as this game moves along. They connected there. They expect to connect on more before this one's over.
The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. Herbert takes it and just pops it forward. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on him before he could get much out of it.
The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on 2nd and goal. Tenth carry now for Derrick Henry. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. A nice run there as he picks up 6. It's going to be 3rd and goal now. Justin Herbert looking to pass to the goal line, but it's incomplete.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
They'll run. It's Henry. And he didn't get there. Knocked backwards to the 2-yard line. The big back Derrick Henry held out of the end zone. And the Browns are able to come up with a goal line stand. The Browns drive about to get started. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done. And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Hunt. He's got a first down past the 30. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Watson. And that's going to be caught by Peoples-Jones. And he'll be stopped right at midfield.
Now what we're seeing, this is much better from this offense because so far in this game, no touchdown to this point. And what's usually a direct correlation? Very few explosive plays. That's been their issue. Not able to make that big shot downfield or break one off. But a nice game there for a first down.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. We have played 3 quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. 42 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point. I tell you, they didn't give it to him much for the first 3 quarters, but when they have, he's been efficient. Maybe they ride him more here down the stretch.
Hey, I'm not sure it was actually in the game plan for him to have as few carries as he has, but it might play out really well for them now. As you noted, if they want to ride him down the stretch, he should have fresh legs.
Here's 2nd and 10. Throwing again is Watson. He's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Sebastian Joseph Day. He's the culprit, dropping him for a 2-yard loss.
It's third down. Third and long.
Going to need something special here on 3rd and long. After that sack, where's Watson having his arsenal? Looking to throw. Watson. fitted into Moore, but it's intercepted. Derwin James with a pick. And the Chargers are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line.
Well, time, I mean, certainly not on their side offensively. They had to take some chances, but that interception will further hinder their already slim chance at victory.
Yeah, and you're talking about time not on their side, but it certainly is on the defense's side, and they understood that. They knew they had to press it a little bit, and they planned accordingly, and what a benefit for them.
This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Allen! Justin Herbert, we saw the big arm in his days in Oregon, of course, saw it even more in his rookie season with the Chargers, and if anything, it appears to just continue to get stronger.
And I'm telling you, nothing will light up a crowd more than a play like that. Here in the stadium, all eyes were on the receiver streaking downfield, and you know everyone was thinking, throw it, he's open. What a connection there for the touchdown.
McCann's got it teed up. And no run back here for Moore. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25. The Browns drive about to get started. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it...
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Jalen Smith, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. The Browns on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This is 3rd and 9. They give the Chubb out of the gun. And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33. Desperation time. Watson on 4th down. Out to his left. And he's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. A give. This is Chubb. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're going to have to find a way to turn the page because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far, and it's cost them.
2nd down, here's Chubb again. And good pursuit yet again by the Chargers as they stuff him behind the line. The tally there, -2 yards, brings up 3rd down. From the gun, here's Watson. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a 1st down. They say he was out of bounds. So a big call there that brings up 4th. And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And Watson has enough for the 1st down yardage as he slides to the turf.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into some windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a 2nd interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the 4th quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a 1st and 10 as they search for a late score. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 92 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now. But
and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Khalil Mack able to record his fifth sack of the season. So maybe just a momentary setback on what's been a great drive so far, but second and 13 here.
And he'll be brought down just outside of the 30.
Faking the give. Now Watson. Rolling to his left. And Watson has enough for the first down yardage as he slides to the turf. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds left to play. On first and 10, Watson. Oh, dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Second and 10. Out of the gun, they run it with Hunt. Pushes him over. They'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead. Here's Watson. Njoku pulls this one in. He's got it for a Cleveland touchdown. David Njoku, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Browns are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter. To throw, Watson toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Popular down near the goal line, quick slant. Nice job there to get in, knock it away.
It was, and one of the other things you're concerned about when you throw that route is to make sure your offensive linemen use their leverage to get the hands of the defensive front down so you can throw it through that little bit of crowd and get it to the receiver. In this event, they did, but a nice play by the defender knocking it away.
They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none.
With the late lead, Herbert's going to throw it. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked by the rookie Greg Newsom. And the Browns are right back in this football game. So this is something we didn't see at all from this offense in the victory last week. That's a turnover. They didn't have any, but giving the ball away here in the opening quarter.
I love the surprise in your voice because it's exactly what you stated. Didn't see it last week, but it was a key to their win. And it'll be.
And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off by Nasir Adderley, and the Chargers come up with a late turnover, but it will probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over.
Well, as always, partner, an extreme pleasure to share a booth with you. I have to say, I am impressed at your discipline because you came here and you said you were not going to eat any of the media buffet. You made it to the end. You didn't consume a single calorie.
I appreciate that. What you missed is me going to the concession stand outside of your eyesight and getting it done that way. Look, I mean, they were serving the good stuff. I had to do it.
Oh, man, but you're svelte, in good shape, but yeah, you cheated a little bit. We'll let it slide.
I appreciate that. Always a pleasure to work with you.
So for the Chargers, they boost their record up to a strong 4-1.